Hey guys, my name is Chanel with the 3A's here on YouTube, 1A in real life, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to make crispy fried chicken. Okay, so the first thing you need, obviously, is a large bowl, and you need your chicken. So I'm using a package of chicken legs. This is just about a pound and a half of chicken legs, and then I'm also using some chicken thighs. You can use chicken breast or whatever you'd like, preferably with the skin on, but I'm using about 2 pounds of this. So in total I have about 3 pounds of chicken, 3.5 pounds of chicken that I'm using. Then I put some water in my bowl so that I can clean my chicken. So I go ahead, I open my chicken, and I put it all in the water and get it all settled in there. And once I've got all the chicken in the water, I like to add some lemon to clean my chicken. I don't like to just rinse it with water. I like to do it with lemon and salt. So I'm using half of a lemon here, and I'm just going to squeeze this all into the water. And then I'm going to use some really heavy salt. You're going to see me grind it in here, but this still comes out really coarse. So I'm going to use some coarse salt. And I'm really just going to rub my chicken down really good, especially with the chicken thighs. I like to get around the skin area and rub it really good just to make sure that it's all clean. And then once I'm done with that, I go ahead and rinse the chicken off. After the chicken is rinsed, I pat it down with some paper towels. You don't have to, but I like to take a little bit of the excess water off so that it doesn't, you know, mess with my seasoning and stuff like that. So I like to pat my chicken dry. An alternative to cleaning your chicken, you can just wash your chicken with plain water if you want. You can use vinegar and water if you want. I mean, there are plenty of ways to clean your chicken. I highly recommend that you clean your chicken instead of not doing it at all, but at least rinsing it down with a little bit of water so that your chicken is clean and prepped and good to go. So for the seasonings, you're going to need some sazon. This is from the Goya brand, but there are plenty of other brands that you can purchase. You can get the Badia brand of this sazon, and you can also get it from a brand called Loisa that I found online that also does sazon and adobo. So don't feel limited to Goya products. I'm using the adobo with saffron, the pink top, and then I'm also using some Creole seasoning, and I'm just gonna put this on my chicken so that we can give it a little bit of flavor. I'm also gonna add some garlic salt. I like garlic salt because I feel like it's a little more bing to it, a little more zazz to it than just garlic powder. The two are totally different for me, so I like to use garlic salt for my chicken just so I can give it that little extra, you know, power. And then I go ahead and mix all of my chicken up and get the seasonings all worked throughout my chicken pieces. Now, I know I did not use any specific measurements. I kind of just eyeballed it for my chicken. But I will try to give you guys some like rough, rounded out measurements in the description box below. So don't forget to check that so that I can, you know, kind of, if you guys aren't comfortable with seasoning your chicken on your own with the amounts to use, I can give you some tips for that. Now, the next thing that you need is some buttermilk. I always forget to buy the damn buttermilk. So I'm using 1 cup of milk and about 1/3 of a stick of butter to make my own buttermilk. You also will need 1 egg. I typically always buy large eggs, so I would suggest a large egg for this. And I'm gonna crack my egg and put it in my chicken. And then I'm gonna add my homemade buttermilk. If you buy your own buttermilk, good on you. If you're making your own homemade buttermilk, there are plenty of recipes online, but it's pretty much just butter and milk, literally. So I get this in there with the seasoned chicken and the egg, and then I mix this all together and let it sit for a little while the oil gets ready and while I prep the flour mixture. Now the key to this chicken getting it crispy is the flour mix. You need some all-purpose flour and you need some cornstarch. The measurements are about 2 to 1 for flour to cornstarch. So I'm taking 1 cup of flour and then I'm gonna take 1/2 cup of the cornstarch, and I'm gonna get this all together in my little bowl, and then I'm gonna season this a little bit. So the first seasoning I'm going to use is some garlic salt, again, because it get a little thing to it. It's a little bit different than garlic powder. So I'm going to take a little bit of garlic salt. That's probably about a fourth of a teaspoon of garlic salt that I'm using. And I'm going to put it in the flour, and then I'm going to take some black pepper. And I'm going to use about another fourth of a teaspoon of black pepper. You don't want to overly season your flour, because I find that when I do that, my chicken always burns. Like the oil gets too hot and it be burning. And stuff like that. So I don't really like to over season my flour, because that's always trouble for me. But maybe you do something different. Maybe your family, you know, knows a different trick, but this is my recipe. So this is what I'm trying to teach y'all right here. Don't over season the flour. Okay. So once you got your flour mix ready, you're going to go ahead and work with your chicken. So you go ahead, drop your chicken into the flour, toss it around, and then you're going to take it to the oil. Now, I have some oil heated here. I don't know the temperature that my oil is heated to, but you know if your oil is burning. The one thing that you don't want to do is burn your oil, because then your chicken is going to burn on the outside before it can cook on the inside. So do not burn your oil. Pay attention to it and make sure that you're careful with how hot your oil gets. But you'll know when your oil is ready. You can always sprinkle a little bit of flour into your oil, and if it dissolves almost like immediately, then your oil is about ready. You can use vegetable oil. I typically use vegetable oil, or you can use canola oil, peanut oil if you like deep frying, but we just pan frying right here. So we just gonna add, you know, some vegetable oil to this. Canola oil, like I said, is kind of a good one, but you need to use a high heat oil. You don't want to use nothing crazy like olive oil, because it ain't gonna work out for you, sis. Now, with your chicken, you're probably going to let this cook for a good 12 minutes, I would say. And this is 3 pieces of chicken right here. Halfway through this, you're going to go ahead and turn your chicken over so that it can cook evenly. But I would say that about 12 minutes is good. However, I always use my meat thermometer when I'm making chicken, because I just have to be sure. And you want your chicken to be at least 165 inside near the bone area, so that your chicken can be cooked thoroughly. One of the issues that I always used to have when I first started making fried chicken and couldn't get it down was my chicken would burn on the outside before it cooked on the inside. And if you're having that problem, your oil is too hot and you need to lower it, or you might be doing something else like previously how I mentioned seasoning my flour was an issue, and it would cause me to burn my chicken before it cooked through. So these some tips, hopefully they're helpful. That's about it. You're gonna have you a nice little plate of fried chicken cooked up, delicious, crispy, seasoned. It's gonna taste good when you take that bite. Just delicious chicken, y'all. So hopefully this was helpful for you guys, and hopefully, you know, y'all's chicken comes out good. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I really hope to see y'all in the next one. I hope you guys are enjoying my cooking little series that I'm working through, and hopefully this is helpful for y'all. So yeah, see you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful.